Welcome back to the Ripe Wave Audio community. My name is John, and for this video, we continue our Ripe Wave Audio series on home theater amplifiers in 2022. And this time it is with Bryston. And this continues the series. It all began many weeks ago with the Monolith by Monoprice brand, followed by Emotiva, Tone Winner, Iota VX, Outlaw Audio, ATI Amplifier Technologies, OSD, NAD, Marantz, Yamaha, Onkyo Integra, Rotel, Arcam JBL Synthesis, AudioControl, Anthem, Starke Sound, Parasound, Primare, Wisdom Audio, Acurus Aragon, and this one, our 21st in the series from Bryston. And Bryston has a wide range of amplifiers that they divide up into monaural, stereo, and multi-channel offerings. And prices range from starting at $5,000 to almost $14,000. And so let's go through this series. And we're going to start with their entry-level product here, the 2.5B cubed stereo amplifier, and this is the slimmest unit that they make. This was introduced, we believe, in 2016, but we don't really have firm dates on these. And also pricing, when you get into these more premium brands, it's harder to get accurate pricing. So if you have corrections on any of this, that would be welcome to the community. But we believe this is $4,995, this two-channel amplifier. They do Class AB. They do Class AB throughout their range. No Class D, no pure Class A, no mix of AAB, all Class AB. And this one delivers it at 135 watts per channel. Now, there's some options on what you get for the cosmetics for the Bryston amplifiers. Now, this one is the white with the 17-inch style, without handles, without the rack-looking ends there. But let's just first look at the rear of this amplifier. And this is giving you both balanced and unbalanced connections. It's giving you input and output triggers through that Phoenix connector. It's a little odd. They don't specify what that power connector is. We believe they probably have 120 and 240 volt versions of this, whether it's auto switching or factory base settings. This isn't made clear in any of their documentation on their website. So again, if you know about the input power on this, that would be helpful to the channel. But it's got some heat sinks on the side of this. This is pretty traditional for Bryston. Now, looking at the cosmetics, these are available in black or white, and in both 17, this is the both 17. I couldn't find an image of this 2.5 B cubed with the 19 inch, but we'll see this as we go along. And looking inside of the 2.5 B3, now these images are not coming from Bryston themselves, but we believe this to be the interior shot. This looks very sparse compared to some of the other models, even given the smaller chassis here. So it's a pretty basic design in the 2.5 model. Now moving up to the B3 cube stereo amplifier, this is $5,995. This is giving 200 watts per channel into those two channels, Class AB, as we said. All these models are going to have both balanced and unbalanced connections. They all have that Phoenix connector, except for the upper models, but they all have triggers. Just the Phoenix connector is on most models, and we'll see that as we go along here. But this is the B3 Cube, and this we do have a picture of what it looks like if you get it with the optional handles. And if it's black, but those handles are also available on the white models. Notice that the black is a little more rugged looking. It has sharper edges than the white version is softer. contours on those details. So you choose what you like the best for your implementation. Moving along to the 4B cubed stereo amplifier, this sells for $7,495. Also two-channel model, but is giving you 300 watts per channel of amplification and the light characteristics on the back. But I will draw our attention to something that's on the 3B cubed as well as the 4B cubed. You have an option of either using the three-prong XLR connectors or a quarter-inch phono jack for those balance connections. Those are specialized dual-type connectors for the balance. So drawing note to that, that was also on the 3B cubed as well. But otherwise, very similar. Notice that these models are having some pretty big heat sinks on the side. And when we look at the color choices here, this is the last one we'll probably show with all the different colors. But regardless of what model you have, you can choose between the white and the black and whether you want the 17-inch without the handles or the 19-inch with the handles, particularly if you're going into a rack mount situation. So this is a 300-watt model, and when we look inside of this, you know, this is a nice clean shot, shows the toroidal power supply in here, the capacitors, and how each channel, one is on the left hand and one is on the right hand side against those heat sinks. So that is the inside of the 4B cubed. Now looking at the 7B cubed, this they've made as a monoblock. So also at $7,495, the single channel is able to put out 600 watts of amplification class AB. And it has that same balance connector that can be either XLR or phono jack. And looking inside of the monoblock, the 7B cubed, you know, you see that same toroidal power supply, you see the same capacitors. So they're probably just doubling up using, taking what would normally be a stereo amplifier and using it as a single channel. And we've seen this as we've gone through the series with some brands. The next model up is a little different. The 9B cubed is got a kind of a modular approach to amplification. This is available as 3, 4, and 5 channel models. And as you can see, they're just slipping in an extra amplifier model and they'll put a module and they'll put a blank in if you got the 4 or the 3 channel where there's empty slots. But regardless, each module is putting out 200 watts of amplification for the respective 3, 4, and 5 channels, all introduced in 2017. So starting with the 3-channel model, that sells for $9,495. For the additional channel, it moves up $1,000 to $10,495. And then the 5 channels, for the extra 2 channels, it's moving up $2,000 to $12,495. So there's some range in between each of those units. Now what you get on the 9B cubed, before we go to the next page, you can see there's an Ethernet jack. And we're starting to see this on some of the multi-channel amplifiers in particular. And we look at the next page here, this is showing you can get a web page information off the amplifier showing the temperature, whether it's going into clipping or protect modes for this amplifier, the serial number, the build date, and et cetera. You get additional information there. Doesn't look like it's giving any configuration options. This is, seems to be purely status here. Looking inside of the 9B cubed amplifier, you can see how that modular it is. In fact, we have a close-up of the module itself, and you can see that each module has its own toroidal power supply, its own capacitors, its own heat sinks in there. So that is a nice shot of the inside of this 19-inch version in black. On the 14B cube stereo amplifier, this one shown in the 19-inch in black, $11,995 for the two-channel amplifier. This is delivering 600 watts per channel, the same balance connections, either XLR or phono jack on this. So that's still carrying through that unique characteristic. We don't see that on a lot of amplifiers. Looking inside, you can see that there's two toroidal power supply on this and that unit. And of course, this is not a factory issued photo, but at least gives you some idea what's going on inside the unit. On the 21B Cube, now this is a unique product. We haven't seen a similar one in this series where it's called a tri-mono. I mean, it's essentially a three-channel amplifier, but they're really positioning this for a single speaker where you take each channel and one delivers the low frequency, one delivers the mid frequencies, and one does a high frequency. So if you have a speaker that supports tri-amplification, this could be a good match for that speaker because you have that dedicated input or dedicated amplifier for each one of the driver frequency ranges. So this sells for $13,795. Not cheap, considering especially if you're going to do this as it's designed, you buy two of these for your two front channels. So that puts you up, you know, like the $28,000 range just for your amplification. So you probably have some pretty decent speakers to utilize this amplifier. And released in 2017, and you can see that it is got XLR balance connectors here. Doesn't support the phono jack, but I would assume you would use regular balance connectors if you're especially at this level here. And also notice on the trigger input and output, they've moved to a phono jack connection versus the Phoenix connection. So there's some changes here as you move up to this level of product. And then looking inside this non-factory photo here, two toroidal transformers, you can see this. They're all kind of laid out very similarly throughout the whole range with Bryston. And now the flagship, the 28B cubed monoblock. And again, very similar looking, but as we'll see inside, this has a little more to it. And they do go back to the Phoenix style connector for the triggers on this model. But you get this big main breaker bar in addition to the power button on the front. And of course, it's available in all the same finishes, 17 inch, 19 inches, black, white, as the other models. But this is delivering the mono channel at 1,000 watts on this. So this is a 1,000 watt unit for this $13,795 unit, which we believe came out around 2017. But when we look inside of this, you can see that the toroidal power supply is a little bigger here. You've got more capacitors. It's probably the cleanest design that we've seen of the whole Bryston series here. Of course, the big heat sinks on the side as we always see on the models. But yeah, the layout is, I think, much cleaner on this flagship. If we move on to the front views, of course, these are all consistent design language. You pick the color and the front style that you want, 17 or 19 inches, handles, no handles. And you can put these together in a rack and or in your room and have them all look the same, which is really nice. Even if you're bringing, you know, in different models, mix and matching. And looking at the back of these, one thing I will point out is the heavier models, the 14B, the 21B, the 28B, they have the additional handles on the back, which is really helpful because these are really heavy here. And you can see also how the 9B is really unique with the modules that it has, 3, 5, or 7 on the back of these. And that the 9B is the only one with an Ethernet jack for those that web page. And looking inside of this, you can see how the quality ramps itself up in the interior, the 2.5 being the simplest. The 3B, we don't have an interior photo, but we think it's very similar to the 4B and the 7B. You know, all have that kind of that similar style there with the single toroidal power supply. You know, it is, you know, that same design platform, we believe. And of course, the 9B with its modular approach and a toroid for each of the modules. The 14B and the 21B look like they're from the same, you know, design language as well, two toroids. The way those capacitors are laid out in the inside. And then, of course, as you move up to the 28B, that quality there, it just seems to stand out from the whole series. And, of course, it should at its price point. And now onto the specifications. Now, what you'll see is the input impedance is 30 kiloohms for the 2.5, the 3B, and the 4B, whether it's balanced or unbalanced connection. But I have a little footnote in here, because if you run these in bridge mode, that drops considerably down to 7 kiloohms for the 2.5 and 5 kiloohms for the 3B. So when you're running in bridge mode, you lose a lot of your input impedance there. The 7B is 10 kiloohm, whether it's balanced or unbalanced. The 9B cubed is 30 kiloohms, balanced or unbalanced. The 14B and the 21B cubed, as well as the 28B cubed, are 7.5 kiloohms unbalanced, 5 kiloohms balanced. So this on the lower side of what we see out there, even for those premium models. They all have input and output triggers. What you'll notice is on the gains here, it's selectable, either 23 decibels for gain. So if you have a source, a receiver, or a processor that has a high output, you could set the gain to 23. But if you have a low output coming from your receiver or your processor, you could set that to 29. And in doing so, it adjusts the input sensitivity. So with higher output receivers and processors, set it to 23, and that's going to give you a higher input sensitivity over 2.3 volts, in some cases almost up to 5 volts on the input sensitivity. And then for receivers, processors with lower output, set it to 29 decibels of gain, which gives you an input sensitivity anywhere between 1.6 and 2.5 volts. So that's nice to have that switch there. Now, the 28B cubed is fixed 29 decibels. You don't have that switching of the gain, and it does the input sensitivity at 3.16 volts. These are all Class AB, as we mentioned before. None of these are fully balanced that we could tell from the literature, but if you know of something otherwise, please let us know. They all support 4 to 8 ohm load impedances. They, for the most part, are all 60 volts per microsecond on the slew rate, except for the 9B cubed, which is 50, but more noticeably, the 28B cubed is 120 volts per microsecond and is the only model that they specify capacitance at 160,000 microfarads. As far as the output power, the 2.5 is the lowest at 135 watts into 8 ohms, 180 watts into 4 ohms. Then you go up with each model. So you've got the 3B at 200 watts, 8 ohms, 300 watts into 4 ohms, the 4B at 300 watts into 8 ohms, 500 watts into 4 ohms, the 7B, which is 600 watts into 8 ohms, 900 watts into 4 ohms, which is the same as the 14B, but the 14B, keep in mind, is a stereo and the 7B is monaural. And then you've got the 9-channel multi-amp, so regardless of whether you have 3, 4, or 5 channels, it's 200 watts per channel, 8 ohms, and 300 watts per channel, 4 ohms. The 21B cubed tri-amplified mono amp is 200 watts into each channel, or 300 watts into 4 ohms. Now, you don't have to use this as intended. You could use this as three channels of amplification. They do something different with the power supply, which we'll mention a little bit here. The 28B3 is 1,000 watts into that single channel, or 1,800 watts at 4-ohm loads. Now, they measure this all at full range, 20 to 20,000 hertz, a low total harmonic distortion on those measurements of 0.005%. So you do get that with this price point, is, you know, that this is truly getting those values out of these amplifiers. The signal-to-noise ratio ranges between 112 decibels up to 122, depending on the model. The highest rated one is the 14B stereo amplifier. That's the 122. The flagship is 117, but not too far different from that. The models which you can bridge are the 2.5, 3, and 4B cubed. You can take the two channels of amplification down to one, so it gives you on the 2.5, 270 watts into 8 ohms, 500 watts for the 3B cubed, and 900 watts for the 4B cubed, all into 8 ohms. They do not specify it for 4-ohm loads, and of course we don't recommend, if they're not specifying, we don't recommend you use it for the lower ohms if they don't talk about it. We didn't talk about cost per channel on the other slide, but these do range on a little higher side. The lowest price model gives you the 2.5 is at $2,500 per channel, and it just goes up there from there, you know, up to almost 14,000 with the 28B cubed on the cost per channel. The next affordable model is the 9B cubed multi-channel, so that ranges from $2,600 for the five-channel model up to $3,165 for the three-channel model. And then everything else is around that $3,000 to $5,000, almost $6,000 range if you include the the 14B3. But that is the cost per channel. So these are definitely a little bit more than some of the more affordable brands that we've seen in this series. Moving on to the dimensions. Now, these are either going to be 17 inches wide or 19 inches wide. So the ones with handles are 19 inches wide or 483 millimeters. The non-handle ones are 17 inches, 432 millimeters. And that's across the board for the whole series. Height ranges from 4.5 inches, 114 millimeters for the 2.5. up to the 14B, 21B, and 28B, which are all 8.1 inches, 206 millimeters. Now, the most shallow unit is the 3B cube stereo model. That's 10.8 inches, 273 millimeters, and that works up to the deepest one is the multi-channel 9B cube, which is 17.5 inches, 445 millimeters. So that's even bigger than some of their premium 14B, 21B, 28B, which are around 16.8 inches deep, 427 millimeters. As far as weight, this starts with the 2.5 being the lightest. That's 28 pounds, 13 kilograms. And you work your way up to the premium models, which are over 91 pounds, 41 kilograms, with the 28B being the heaviest at 110 pounds, 50 kilograms. So no wonder they put extra handles on those models. These all have removable IEC power cords, which is good to see, but we're really unclear about the voltage there. So they don't really tell you if these come with 120 volt or 240 volt support, if it's auto switching, or do you have to set that by the factory. We think it's probably a factory setting. They do mention something that it will say it on your power cord, but it's not written on the back of the unit. But we do know that they all are toroidal power supplies, linear power supplies, which is good. They at least have one. The 2.5 has two toroids. So does the 14B and the 21B. And the 9B has a toroid for every module, so either 3, 4, or 5 toroids on those. Power consumption starts at 665 watts for the 2.5 and works up to 7,500 watts for the 21B. That uses the most power. That seems really high. And the damping factor of 500 is pretty much for most models except the 7B, 9B, 14B, and 21B, which are all 300 on the damping factor. We don't see any fans on any of these models, which is good. They have some pretty big heat sinks on them. So that wraps it up for Bryston. So what do you think about this premium company? They have a long history. They've been well respected over the years. Do you think they're still putting out quality amplifiers in comparison to either with its peers at a similar price or even with some of the more entry-level brands like Mono Price and Emotiva and OSD, etc.? That feedback would be useful to the RipeWave audio community. And if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. And if you want to take it to that next level, go to www.patreon.com/RipeWave and become a Patreon so you'll have access to our database, to our PowerPoint presentation, so you can do your own comparisons with that spreadsheet. And I think that's a real useful tool. But regardless, you can always hit the bell icon so you'll be notified when the next video is posted. Until then, keep evolving your audio experience.